So this video is going to be a little bit different. I've had some people reach out to me recently and they said, all right, Aaron, I know that you about a month and a half ago, you started promoting your Facebook Marketplace dropshipping automation service. And they wanted to know how that was going for my clients, how the people that signed up for me, signed up with me and have me run their store for them, how their stores are doing. And the answer might surprise you because what you will see, I'm actually going to take you behind the scenes and pull back the curtain here in about 30 seconds. I'm going to show you a bunch of the stores. I'm going to show you the sales that they've gotten, some of the struggles that they're having, along with some of the successes as well. And then, well, with that said, let's go ahead and do that now. So let's go ahead and jump on over to my screen, and I'll show you how some of these stores are doing and some of the issues that are happening too. So this is an email I got from Nick. He signed up with me about 5 weeks ago. He says, hey Aaron, so my taxes on status has been approved and I see it started. Also, I see my dropshipping account is now accepting all orders. We did have some issues with orders going through. It took about a week and a half to resolve. I know exactly how to fix this. I have a 100% success rate on fixing this. But, you know, it wasn't a perfect ride, for the first, I'd say about week of 5, 7, 8 days. He goes, looks like I'm getting about 2 orders every day now, which is great. And then he sent me a couple other, kind of inconsequential questions too. So it's great. Nick signed up with me about 5 weeks ago. We got his store up and running. I had his store launched and a team in his store 3 days after he signed up. And now he's getting about 2 orders every day and he's very excited for it and looking forward to the future. These are a couple other stores that I'm running. This store has 5 active orders that are waiting to go out. This store has 6 active orders. These are not total orders sold in the store. These are just orders that people have bought in the last few days that need to be shipped. The other thing to be aware of with this is you basically have 3 days, unless it's the weekend, you have basically 3 business days to get the item shipped. Well, with the dropshipping companies we use, sometimes the tracking number is available in 1 to 2 days. So just because like the store has 5 orders showing 5 open orders in the last few days, there's a good chance, I didn't look at the sheet, I could have, but there's a good chance the store had closer to 6 to 7 to 8 orders because their orders that are, 2, 3 days old, that tracking number could have been available. And what we do is every day we look at all the open orders and anytime there's a tracking number available, we don't wait till the day it needs to be marked as shipped. We get it shipped the day the tracking number is available. Here's another store. It has waiting to be shipped. And then you see at the bottom, it says shipped 44 items. Now this might not seem like a lot and it's not a ton of sales, but remember, most of my stores that have started with me are 1 to 2 months old. I do have some stores that are a little bit longer, but let's say this store started about 7 weeks ago with me. And, there's usually a little bit of ramp up time and, to be having 6 open orders that need to be shipped. So that means there's probably closer to 8 orders that happen in a 3-day period, 2, 3 sales a day is not too bad, especially when we're doing these dollar amounts. I want you to pay attention to these dollar amounts as well because we do about 25% profit. So it's not just about the sales you're getting. The other thing you have to understand is how much profit you're making. But 25% profit on $97 is about 20, 25 bucks. This $394 order, the profit on this is about 100 bucks. The profit on this is going to be about $40, about $40 here. Waiting to be shipped, 4 items, shipped total 36, another store. This is another store I'm running, waiting to be shipped, only 3. So this store over the last few days, the sales have not been that many. What is nice is the dollar amount is high, $207. So, that's about $50 profit. This is about $60, $70 profit. But not all stores are, there's issues and there's ups and downs with stores, just like any business. Pending balance on one of the accounts I'm running is 803. Another pending balance, 843, which is not bad. This is a little bit of a slower store, 701. This is Nick. This is actually the guy that messaged me. This is a sales sheet. So you can see so far in the month of August, he's gotten a little bit over 30 orders. So he's happy. This is another automation client. This is actually Devin's sales sheet. All these sales are for the month of August. And it actually goes up higher than this. I just couldn't screenshot it because that's when it ran out. But, you know, Devin's store is about 35-ish, 40 sales for the month of August so far. This is a guy's store I'm running. His name is Sid. Again, you see everything here is for the month of August. Sid's doing just fine. This is another store, 7 open orders. And again, you see the important thing to think about is not only the sales, but also the dollar amount. 25% on $333 is pretty good. You know, even 25% on $113. If you're making $20, $30, $50, $80 profit per sale, it can add up. You know, $104, this is a $392 sale. So, you know, if you're making about $100 profit on that, that definitely add up. Pending balance here, this is another store, $1,338 for a pending balance. And these are just some of the stores. So let's go ahead and talk about some things to be aware of with this. As you can see, so far, these stores are doing good. And the reason is I know exactly how to run this space. It's not like I just got started in this recently. I've been dropshipping for over 2 years. I used to dropship on Amazon back before all the account suspensions and, you know, basically where it's impossible to have longevity there. And last year I did over $100,000 in profit dropshipping on Amazon. I'm very familiar with running teams and the entire dropshipping business model. I've been doing this for a while, so I know how to solve different issues that come up. And although you saw a lot of different stores that I'm running right now that are having success, that are making money, there's also challenges. Not all stores are different. I have a few stores now that I'm having issues with where they're slow down in sales. Now, usually when they're slow down in sales, usually it's just a store that's in the beginning that either is running through some issues that generally gets worked out. I had a client message me about a month ago. This was a newer, an older client of mine. He signed up with me, was getting sales for a while, and then it went like two and a half weeks, guys. If I'm being fully transparent, it went a couple weeks where he didn't get any sales. He emails me, he's freaking out. I said, it's part of the process. There's glitches that happen on Facebook. And then sometimes there's other issues. Like sometimes I gotta hire and fire virtual assistants a few times till I find ones that meet my expectations for your store. So there's different issues. I said, just give it time. I'm working on it. Just be patient. Time went on and he started getting sales again. He emailed me, said, all right, Aaron, everything's good. Sometimes you know what happens if you run into a slow spot for a week or two. Sometimes people, you know, all humans kind of have a tendency to just kind of think that's how things are going to be forever. I'm continuing to grow your store. I know what I'm doing. I know the best products to list in your store to get you the most amount of sales as quickly as possible. I know how to list those products so they beat the competition. Hell, you can find interviews where I even teach in my program, not even the automation, but just a regular program where my student Phil, he talks about how he lists items for, he had one of his best-selling items, he saw a competitor was selling it for less. He said, oh, well, I guess everyone's going to buy the competitor's item. What he didn't realize is over the next week or two, and he says this in the video interview that's on my YouTube channel, he says that he continued to get sales even though his item was listed more than the competition. A lot of people that don't know what they're doing in this space, they think it's, they don't understand. They think it's just about pricing the item being cheaper than the competition. When you know what you're doing, you can hack Facebook Marketplace's algorithm and basically get Facebook to show, essentially, it's not like this 100%, but it's virtually getting being able to hack Facebook Marketplace's algorithm and get your items listed at the top, get Facebook to show your items at the top, even if you're selling your items for more than the competition, which is exactly what I do for my clients. So if you're interested in learning more about how I can run your Facebook Marketplace dropshipping business from start to finish, I run it, I handle it, so it's making you automated residual income. There's every now and then a couple little things I need you to do, but we'll say it's 99.8% automated, just to be safe. There's a link below you can click to learn more about how you can have me run your store for you. So it's hands-off and it makes you automated residual income.